हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, अगेन वी आर हेयर फॉर द टॉपिक सब्जेक्ट वर्ब अग्रीमेंट। वेलकम टू योर इंग्लिश क्लास। वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट सब्जेक्ट वर्ब अग्रीमेंट, द टॉपिक ऑफ द डे। सो एज वी हैव अर्लियर डिस्कस्ड दैट सब्जेक्ट विल अग्री विद वर्ब, दैट कॉल सब्जेक्ट वर्ब अग्रीमेंट। इफ द सब्जेक्ट इज सिंगुलर देन द वर्ब विल बी singular and the subject is plural, then verb will agree that plural. Okay, but to know more and to just justify this, we will discuss with examples here in the video. Here first of all we have discussed that a sentence is a group of words that contains a subject and a predicate and makes complete sense by itself. This is as a revision we are doing. Okay, first of all, to do subject verb agreement, what is subject, what is verb, for that we rectify in sentence. And to know about it more, firstly we should know about that sentence. What is sentence? So a sentence is a group of words that contains a subject and a predicate and makes complete sense by itself. Like, Fleck is very set. The two tickets are bought by Fleck. Fleck is very sad. Okay, subject is Fleck is very sad is predicate. What is subject? Subject is who is performing. And what is predicate? Apart from subject, what is remaining in the sentence is predicate. The two tickets are bought by Fleck. So here the subject is the two tickets and are bought by Fleck is predicate. Okay, the subject and the predicate. The two tickets is subject and are bought by Fleck is predicate. Here, the subject refers to the person, place, animal or thing that is being spoken about in the sentence, and the predicate tells us more about the subject. The predicate contains the verb. The most important thing to keep in mind is the predicate contains the verb. Zizi meets her uncle on weekends. So from the verb like meets, it started the sentence is predicate. And the sentence having the subject Zizi. Zizi is subject. Meets her uncle on weekend is predicate here. Next, the subject. Now we will know about the subject more. To find a subject, ask the question. If you want to know what is subject, then you must ask the question, who or what? Who or what? Who draws in her art book? Zizi draws in her art book. Like, I am teaching you. Who is teaching you? Okay. You are listening me. So, who is listening me? Okay. We are studying subject and predicate. Who are studying subject and predicate? Like this, by putting question who or what, you can come to know that what is the subject in the sentence. Got it? Next, the subject. The subject is made up of only one word or more than one word. Okay? Subject is made up of, it contains one word or more than one word. The subject may be made up of a noun or a pronoun or a group of words acting like a noun. Okay, it can contains noun, pronoun or a group of words acting like a noun. A word or a group of words that tell us something more about the noun or pronoun. Clear? These two conditions are for the subject. Next, the simple subject. Simple subject means what? Example, the fair has lots of rides. This is quite clear to you. Who has lots of rides? The fair. The subject contains definite article, the, and noun, fair. Okay, nothing else is here. The subject contains definite article and the noun. The art book is full of drawing. The subject contains the definite article, the, adjective and the noun book. Okay, adjective art and the noun book. Got it? So here subject are very simple. Moving to the next one. The simple subject like he and Zizi love playing games. He and Zizi love playing games. Now you think what is the subject here? He and Zizi. Here are two. He and Zizi. Can you think there is only one subject? Either he or Zizi? No. We know that predicate contains verb. So before verb means before love. He and Zizi is there. So don't be confused. He and Zizi. The both person is subject here. The subject contains pronoun he and conjunction and the noun Zizi. Okay. So a word or a group of words. So here the term is clear to you. A group of words. He and Zizi is group of words which form the most important part of the subject is called a simple subject. The other words only tells us more about the simple subject. Yani what is being done, what is being performed, what is happening and who is performing is subject and what is the subject performing is the predicate. Okay, moving to the next one. Subject verb agreement. In number, now we will discuss number. Like the subject of a sentence is made up of a noun, a pronoun, a group of nouns or a group of words acting as noun. What does it mean? A subject of a sentence, this is quite clear to us, is made up of noun or pronoun, a group of nouns or group of words, and it act as noun. Okay? Means whether it is a group of words, but it act as noun. Since a noun or pronoun can be either singular or plural in number, the subject can be either singular or plural. Okay? Since a noun or pronoun can be singular or plural, so subject can be singular or plural. The verb like the noun and the pronoun has two numbers, singular and plural. Here we come to know, as the subject is singular and plural, so the verb is also singular and plural. Like, I go to market. He goes to market. So here you can see go and goes, singular and plural form of verb. So you can see that the verb like the noun and the pronoun has two numbers, singular and plural. Moving to next. Here subject, verb agreement, number. Whatever we have discussed, we will just quote the example of that. Examples, she laughs. The subject is singular, therefore the verb is singular. They laugh. The subject is plural, therefore the verb is plural. And only it makes subject verb agreement. Subject is singular, therefore the verb is singular. Some more example like they eat, she eats. We go, he goes. You like, she likes. So like this we can give some more example of singular and plural verb and subject. Now subject verb agreement, verb person. We will discuss about the verb person. The verb like the personal pronouns has three persons. The first person, the second person and the third person. The verb like the personal pronouns has three persons. The first person, the second person and the three person, third person. Like in a sentence, if the subject is of the first person, the verb will also be the first person and so on. Means if the subject is second person, then verb will be according to that only. Like I laugh, you laugh, she laughs. It follows the rule. I eat, you eat, she eats. I cook, you cook, she cooks. I go, you go, she goes. Okay, so here the rule says like this. Moving to the next one, subject verb agreement, verb person and number. In a sentence, the verb must always agree with its subject in person and in number. The verb must always agree with its subject in person and in number, like we have discussed person in number. If it is I or we, then it will be the plural form, like I go, we go. In a sentence, the verb takes the same person as its subject. We can consider all nouns as pronoun of the third person. In a sentence, the verb takes the same number. In a sentence, the verb takes the same number as its subject. If the subject is singular, the verb must be singular. If the subject is plural, the verb must be plural. Simple. Subject is singular, then verb will be singular. Here you can see this, whatever we have discussed will be proven in the next video. But keep in mind, in a sentence the verb takes the same person as its subject, okay, and in a sentence verb takes the same number as its subject. Like subject is singular, verb must be singular, and subject is plural, then verb must be plural. Why we are again and again telling this? Because subject should be agrees with verb and verb should be agrees with subject. Only then it makes subject verb agreement. Now just have a look on this table. Here you can see in the first column person, here number, singular and plural, first person, second person, third person. So we will see how the singular number and how the person will frame. I sing, you sing, he, she, it sings. Okay, singular first person, I sing. Singular second person, you sing. Singular third person, he, she, it sings. Lucy sings. A parrot sings. Singular. But when we talk about the plural one, it's we, first person plural, sing. You used in both cases, either it is singular or plural. I am talking to the single student, only to one, like Divyajit, so it is you. When I'm talking to the whole class, then I will also mention you. So you sing, and third person, they sing, and parrots sing. So here singular noun, singular verb, singular subject, singular verb, plural subject, plural verb. Okay, next. Now I hope it should be quite clear to you. Now we will discuss the next one, that is subject I. When the first person I is the subject in a sentence, we need to be very careful about the form of the verb. When the first person I is the subject in a sentence, we need to be very careful. How? I sing songs, present tense. I have sung songs, present perfect tense. I takes a plural verb. I takes a plural verb. I is exceptional here. So I is singular in number, but it takes plural verb, like I go, we never write I goes. It's wrong. In the present tense and present perfect tense, we use a plural verb with the subject I. Okay. Only in the present tense and present perfect tense. Why? Because in present tense, we are having rule using S and ES. But when we talk about the past, we are only having was. Can we use was with everything? And when we talk about the future, we use will and shall. There is no matter of number there. But here, this is a matter of number in present. So, we have to follow this. Now here, present perfect, we are having has and have in present. So, has come with singular and have come with plural. But in case of I takes have. But in past perfect, we are only had. We are only had. And had used with I, we, you, they, everything. Okay? So, keep in mind when you are in present. I have also told you the reason why you will use I in plural with plural form in present tense and present perfect tense due to this reason. Okay? Moving to next, the subject I. Also note that for singular subject using words such as will and shall in the future perfect tense, the plural verb is used. See, I shall have sung, we will have sung. Also note that for singular subject using words such as will and shall in the future perfect tense, the plural verb is used. I shall have sung, we will have sung. Okay. Moving to next, subject verb agreement. Here, while writing sentences, there are a few more important points that you need to remember to ensure that the verb agrees with the subject. Means, as we have already done some points, but for we should know more, and there are some more points that we should discuss. Here, the rules are, rule number one, when a sentence has two singular subjects joined by the conjunction and, the verb usually used is plural here. The verb usually used is plural here. When a sentence has two singular subjects, first of all, keep in mind there are two singular subjects, but the subjects are joined with a conjunction like and, then usually it is plural, like Roy and Lara are going to the fair. I and you are reading books. I and you are learning English. So when it becomes two, joining with and, it will considered as plural subject, and then the verb will here used as plural verb. Okay, next. Rule number two, if two singular nouns are used to refer to the same subject or express one idea, the verb used is also singular. See, this is quite different. If two singular nouns used or refer as same subject, means it will considered as same idea or one idea, the verb used is singular, like bat and ball is used to play cricket. The singer and dancer is going to perform at the fair. Because one sing and one dance is considered as one. The bread and butter is kept on the table. I have taken bread and butter. So bread and butter is considered one. In the same manner, the bat and ball is used to play cricket. And the singer and dancer is going to perform at the fair. So these are the case where the noun adjoining with and but is considered as one. Okay, keep this in your mind. Next, here rule number four, that is words such as news, information and advice also takes a singular verb. News, information and advice also takes a singular verb, like the sports news is playing on television. News itself is plural and will considered as singular also. Whenever we talk about such word like news and information and advice, these are considered as singular. The sports news is playing on television. No information was given to us about the meeting. The counselor gave me some excellent advice. Okay. The counselor gave me some excellent advice. So here it will considered as singular verb. Next, subject verb agreement. Here, this is we have discussed about news, information and advice that used as singular. Now we will do revision, means we will do a recapitulation what we have learnt
today, like it is subject verb agreement. What did I learn today? First of all, here we will discuss with the predicate tells us more about the subject. First of all, it's 1-2-3 rule. Let me tell you about this. First of all, we have started with subject and the predicate. First of all, we have discussed that subject is a group of sentence having a meaning, okay, or a meaningful group of sentence is sentence. Then we come to know that it's having two parts, okay. Then point number third is it is one part is subject and the predicate. Subject tells about the doer and predicate. Then number four, its fourth point is the predicate tells us more about the subject. The predicate contains the verb. Clear? Coming to the fifth point, to find a subject, we ask the question who and what plus predicate. Then next point is the subject is made up of a noun or a pronoun or a group of words acting like a noun and a word or a group of words that tell us something more about the word. Next, seventh, a word or group of words which form the most important part of the subject is called a simple subject. The other words in the subject only tells us more about the simple subject. Next point, a noun or a pronoun can be either singular or plural in number. Hence, the subject can be either singular or plural. Okay, next, we learnt that the verb like the noun and the pronoun has two numbers, singular or plural. Then, next, in the present tense and present perfect tense, we use a plural verb with the subject I sing, I have sung, and we have discussed it also. Singular subject using words such as will and shall in the future perfect tense takes the plural verb. Example, I shall have sung, he will have sung. Next, when a sentence has two singular subjects joined by the conjunction and the verb usually used is plural. Okay, like Zizi and Fleck are watching television. I and you are listening the video. So here this is what we have learnt about subject verb agreement. Here the topic finished. Learning English is not enough and cannot be bound in slides or in videos. Still we have learnt a lot, but still we have many more to learn. Okay, keep the rules in your mind. When you will do more exercises, then you will come across the rules, many more rules, and whatever you have learned will be proven with that work only. So read it again, listen it again, and do the assignment that I am giving you. Here are some very easy assignments to just beginning for the beginning of the topic. Here now you need not to color the subject in blue and predicate. You only need to circle and underline, or you can do color for the fun only. And then to the next slide, here this one and this slides. Okay, this you will do and send to me on my personal number. Do the homework, be active and keep in touch, beta. Everyone do your work. Okay. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.